Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to look at Headless Hashnode. If you're new to Hashnode, it's a popular blogging platform where you can go on, set up a blog, you have access to a very nice editor, you write your blog post and you share it with the world, right? But there's this new feature that they just announced last week called Headless Hashnode that allows you to use your Hashnode blog as a CMS. And that is something that I want to dig into today. So this is the announcement website. So if you click on the Explore APIs, it gives you immediate access to a GraphQL playground where you can, you know, run some queries to see how you can fetch some of your blog posts, right? But I'm not going to play around with that. Feel free to do that if you're new to the playground. I'm going to directly go ahead and start building with this, right? What I want to do is I have a mentorship program that I have this website for. It's called dxmentorship.com. I want to use Hashnode to kind of like power the blog functionality of this website. So right now I have that on Hashnode. This is dxmentorship.hashnode.dev. What I want to do is set up a subdomain for this DX Mentorship website so that if you go to say blog.dxmentorship.com, you would get access to this Hashnode blog where we put out our mentorship blog post. Basically, that's it, right? So let's dig into it. According to the documentation, the first thing you need to do is fork the GitHub repository. So let's do that. So I'm going to fork this onto my repository and I'm going to call it DXM blog. Right. And this is the blog starter kit with Hashnode GraphQL APIs and Tailwind CSS because that is what we used for styling. Create this fork. So this is just going to take like a few seconds and we will have that available. Okay, so now that this is created, this is a mono repo and it has two teams. The first team is an enterprise team. The second one is a personal team. I prefer the enterprise team. I think it's very much better than the personal one. So I'm going to go into that team and I'm going to copy the environment variable example because I will need that when I deploy this site. The documentation recommends that we deploy on Vercel, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to go to Vercel and I'm going to try to basically add a new project. We should see the DXM blog and I'm going to import this one. So again, this is a mono repo, so we will need to set the root directory. In this case, I'm going to set it to that enterprise team that I talked about just now. So this is the one. I'm going to set that as the root directory. The framework preset is Next.js. So let's select that. And then the environment variables that I talked about, I'm going to paste that one that I copied. This is going to stay the same. This one is going to be DX Mentorship. Actually, I'm going to copy it from the playground so that I don't make any mistakes having to type it out. So I'm going to paste that here and I'm going to change this to production. And I think that's it. So let's hit deploy. With any luck, we should get everything the way we want it without any issues. If there are any issues, then we will just do a bit of debugging and fix that. But so far we are following the documentation. So I don't think there's going to be any problems. If you haven't done this before, I've spent some time just looking at the documentation and figuring out what exactly I need to do. So you should also follow the documentation yourself if any of these processes doesn't work for you. And the documentation is right here on the repo. So look at the README file. You should have all you need there. So I'm going to come back here. Our deployment is still going. So let's just give it a couple more minutes. And it looks like our deployment is successful. So if you look at this, actually, let's go and look at that. I think it's going to look exactly like this. Fantastic. So I see some of the blog posts that I have on Hashnode showing up here. So if you look back on Hashnode, you see that we get exactly the same thing, except this time we have it on this new domain. All right, so back at Vercel, what I'm going to do is, remember at the beginning, I talked about how I want this blog to be hosted on my DX Mentorship domain. That's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to switch over to the settings and come over to domains. And here I'm going to add a new subdomain, and it's going to be blog.dxmentorship. Also, remember that at this point, this subdomain doesn't exist, so I don't expect this to work out of the box. I will have to go to my hosting provider and configure it. So this is blog.dxmentorship.com. So let's add that. Sure enough, we get an invalid configuration, and that is because I bought this domain from name.com. So I'm going to head over to name.com and let me add a new record so that this will propagate. So I'm going to copy the Vercel DNS value here. And here I'm going to add a CNAME, and the subdomain is going to be blog, and the value is going to be, I'm going to remove the trailing dot and click on add record. And sure enough, we have that record added now. So I'm going to go back to Vercel and I'm going to reload the page. Okay, actually don't have to do that because Vercel refreshes that for you. So with any luck, when we go to blog.dxmentorship.com, we should also now be able to see this particular project. I'm going to come back to my Hashnode blog, and I'm going to do the headless settings, right? And this is a very important part, because this will then tell Hashnode to not generate a UI for this blog, but instead use this blog as a headless CMS provider that basically feeds content to that domain. So I'm going to hit on the advanced tab. I'm going to scroll all the way down to use Hashnode as a headless CMS. Right now I'm on DX Mentorship, which is a team account. So this is going to require me to fill a form to request for access. But if you're on a personal account, you just get a toggle that you just hit. Actually, let me see if I can show you how that works. I'm going to go to Kenny, which is my personal account. And if you come to advanced settings again, you should see this option. So basically all you need to do is toggle this button and it will start using this blog as a headless CMS provider to feed content to that your custom domain that we've created. So I'm not going to do that yet. I haven't filled up that account, that form yet to request for that access. But I think this would work the way that I want it to anyways. So I'm going to come back to my Vercel account. I'm going to click on this new subdomain that we've added. I think it has propagated. And sure enough, we now get this DX Mentorship blog showing up on blog.dxmentorship.com. So it could be really that simple to basically use Hashnode to feed your blog content into your company's website or into your personal website, or you know, wherever you want that to happen. I think that this is pretty cool. But I'm really interested in the headless Hashnode part of it, which is something that I'm looking forward to. I am going to fill that form and I'm going to get that access. But in the meantime, this is amazing, right? And it has a lot of things out of the box. The search would work if I try to search for, let's say, Hacktoberfest. I will get the search results showing up and just a couple of different things like newsletter that comes with it out of the box. It still has my internal Hashnode configurations. You see that I've got the website link on the navbar, which is a setting that I set on Hashnode. So a couple of things are really interesting here. I think this is a very good starter kit. It allows you to basically build and put a blog on your custom domain in a matter of what, a few minutes without all the back and forth. So I think this is powerful. I want you to check it out if you have the time or if you're looking for something like this. Let me know what your thoughts are. Try to use the APIs, try to check the headless Hashnode feature and share your thoughts. Just a disclaimer that this is not a sponsored content, so I'm just making this video purely because I think it's going to be helpful to you. So if that is the case, let me know in the comments and I will see you in the next one. Bye.